about working on films is that, you know, a lot of times you're working with creative people who bring really good and interesting references to the table, and so I get to interface with new types of music.
When he called up and said, is this something you're interested in, it wasn't even like he had to pitch it to me. It was just like, of course I am. I think the word thunder and drums and a few other things in that zone came up.
We really wanted to have Lars do was to really help with creating a driving energy for the score.
You know, Rich wrote this beautiful, beautiful, rich music, and to then just have, you know, those drums, which are so sort of identifiable and symbolic, just that willingness to kind of try things is rare.
JC's idea was basically, was there a place where I could create an atmosphere or tension or something else that would take the visuals and the scenes to a different place? So if you take the helicopter scene, I mean, the way it's filmed, where's the balance between what's going on visually, and I guess I feel our job or my job is to support that, but always being conscious of never trying to take over.
We're redlining, man. It's close, though.
At the point where the helicopter sort of reaches the apex and then, you know, redlines and it has to go back down, that's where it was the end of the day and I didn't have any more time. And so, but there was a bunch of drums after that and I was like, oh, I'll do that later. But I just sent what I had and I was like, oh, you know, I didn't finish the second half yet, it's just drums. And they were like, we actually love it with just drums. And I was like, yeah, actually, that is kind of cool. It's different.
Okay, we might be in trouble here.
The senior producer on this project has done a lot of amazing action movies. And the thing that he said to me about that sequence was, you know, we didn't have music in it for a long time and we were showing it to audiences. And then I told him I was going to, you know, work with Rich on putting something in there. And he said, well, you know, that sequence has been working really, really well without music. So now if you put the cherry on top, it's only going to get better.
I would say for me, an incredible takeaway from this was really letting myself into Rich's world as the composer and really understanding the fine details of the score.
What's cool about soundtracks is it puts the listener into the director's chair. I think it speaks to the subjectivity and the versatility of music. It can mean a lot of different things to a lot of different people.